Good morning, everyone. I'm here a little bit early today, but I wanted to make sure we get this video done. God has so much He wants to say to us. But before we begin, I am Dee Knupp, and I am partners with Power and Unity Ministries. And I am here to wish all mothers everywhere a wonderful Mother's Day for tomorrow, hoping that your children will take you out and treat you the special person that you are. I would like to take this time just to tell my daughter, I think you're a great mother. Praise be unto God for who you are in the spirit and who you are to your family. To my sisters, Carol and Ann, I'd love to wish them a happy Mother's Day and hope that they're able to do something, kids are able to do something special for you. And the same thing for my best friends. I've had three really good friends, prayer partners throughout my life. Two Carolyns and one Marilyn. And one of them, my friends, has been a friend now for probably near 60 years now, and that's hard to believe. But I want to wish them a very, very happy Mother's Day. And there's so many of my friends I would like to call out, but I just took this time, since it's personal to me, to thank God for the friends that He's given to me and the wonderful family that I have. I want to give you just a little bit of a mother's poem that I put together years ago, and I just want to say something to the mothers today, because if it wasn't for mothers, there wouldn't be anything going on, right? Praise be unto God. Whether it be a girl or a boy, mothers raise them all. Praise God. This poem says, "Mother is such a simple word, but to me, the true meaning is seldom heard. She is outgoing, a nurse, a cook, domestic engineer, taxi driver, teacher, and the first to cheer. She is mature but playful, bookkeeper and friend, at work in the neighborhood or at home, you blend. Full of wisdom and warmth and love, a blessing surely from above. May the Lord bless you on this your special day and hold you close all along life's way." These are just a few things my memory I bore. I am sure that you can think of many more. May God bless mothers all over the world today and tomorrow as we celebrate Mom's Day. Praise be unto God. Now I want to get into the Word of God today also, because He has so much that He wants to tell us. You need to listen close when the Lord speaks. When He says something over and over again, you got to know that He's wanting you to listen. Just like Peter, He asked him three times. He says, "Peter, do you love me?" He said, "Yes, feed my sheep." "Peter, do you love me?" "Yes, Lord, I love you. Feed my lambs." "Peter, do you love me?" And Peter said, "Yes, Lord, you know I love you. Feed my sheep." So when He speaks, He means for us to listen and to be obedient and do what He asks us to do. Of course, as usual, most of the time it starts out with me talking. But anyway, I just want you to be very much aware of all the things that He says, because He talks about how He loves us. He talks about what's before us. He warns us of things that are coming, but He tells us who He is in all of this. He is in charge. This earth, this world, this galaxy belongs to Him. It doesn't matter what it looks like around us. He said, "Focus on me and you will see." Let me just go ahead and start now. I love just talking to you. I feel like I have friends all over the world, and we just talk. We just talk as if we're sitting at a table over a cup of coffee. And that's the way it is with the Lord and I. I feel like we just talk. He is so, well, It's going to tell it in here how I feel in my heart. I start out by saying, Lord, what would you have me do? I just want to stay close to you. Should I read or pray? As with you, I gladly stay. Should I wait for you to speak? As I stay humbled at your feet, where in your presence all earthly things die and my spirit begins to rise. May my ears be open to hear as you draw close, I draw close and you draw near. May my ears be in tune as you enter the room. Jesus, I call revelations to come before this week is done. Your word says, ask and you shall receive. I am asking indeed. You have already given me so much, words and poetry, visions and such. But my soul is so hungry for more of what I know you have in store. The road sometimes is rough, but I can never seem to get enough. More of you my heart cries for, as at your feet I sit on the floor. Since you rescued me, in your presence is where I want to be, basking in your love sent from heaven above. Jesus, in your letter to all mankind, you are the one who created all space, grace, and time. There are no earthly words to say how you touch my heart each day. Now, if you love Jesus and you are serving him to your fullest, you can't tell me that that is not what your heart speaks this morning. Then he says to me, and you're going to have to know, sometimes I dance before the Lord, sometimes I shout, sometimes I cry, sometimes I just start singing. A song just comes to mind and I can't get it out of my head and I'll just start singing it. But this morning I was dancing before the Lord and he says to me, ooh, hallelujah, I saw you dancing before me this morning, twisting and turning, me adorning. I was making love to my Lord. You captured my eye, and for you I have a great surprise waiting inside as I open the door wide. You know, yesterday he talked about cracking the door. Then he talked about slamming it wide open. He keeps talking about opening that door. That's the hope we need to hold on to, knowing what he has said is true. He will open that door one day, and your ministry is going to flourish. You just watch. Watch. Just the thought, I say, of the God of space and time takes time with me to wine and dine. A God, you've heard this when you were a child, a God so big that he formed the world, and yet he's small enough to live in my heart. That's what it's saying here. I'm saying, as the God of space and time takes time with me to wine and dine. It just blows my mind because he's so holy and he's so divine. Then he goes back to talking. My watchful eye has been over you since birth and every day since you've walked this earth. Now remember, when he's talking this morning, not just to me, he's talking to you. He watches over you since the day you breathed your first breath. And every day since you've walked this earth. I am about to turn the tide, Jesus says, that will cause a great divide. Remember, listen to what he's telling us. Then you will understand more of what you were birthed for. For every soul, I have a plan to help save fallen man. All are called, many do not respond. I do not wave a magic wand. I sent my precious son to die for everyone. His blood he gave from the cradle to the grave. For all mankind he died. Now he sits beside my right, he sits at my right side. Praise God. There are not no big I's and little U's. There is no red, white, blue, yellow, pink, purple, polka dotted. There is all mankind. We all have to come to the same cross to receive the same Christ. He doesn't see color. He doesn't see where you were born, whether you were born with a silver spoon or whether you've had to sweep a room. He doesn't see. What he sees is the heart. That's why the word says, guard your heart. Guard your heart against the enemy and against the flood of deception and confusion. Guard your heart. How do we do that? We say in the Word of God, trust in Him with all your heart. Lean not on your own understanding, but in all ways acknowledge Him, and He will direct your path. Whew, hallelujah to the Lamb. Now, part of this I've read before because God has told me to warn the people about keeping their lamps burning bright. So you're going to hear some very familiar stuff here in a minute. He says, all are called, not all respond. I do not wave a magic wand. I sent my precious Son to die for everyone. I tell you again, as I've told you before, you're about to hear the lion roar. As the earth begins to shake, the enemy's stronghold I break. Idols will crumble and governments will tumble. There is no stuttering as I speak. I speak plain to the humble and the weak. Praise God. No matter what you see, you're always safe in me. I have the devil by the tail. None of his plans will prevail. You hear that? He didn't stutter. He didn't stutter. I have the devil by the tail, and none of his plans will prevail. For I am in charge, and those I love I guard. There's no reason to fear when we live for Jesus. Warn my people to keep their lamps burning bright, for there is coming a fight. Do not let your oil run low, for you will need to know the way to go. I am bringing my people into one accord as I shake earth to its core. I will sever the head of the snake as many to my spirit awake. They were blind before, but not anymore. To the cross they now sing, worshiping Jesus, their Lord and King. The Spirit of God, He is awaking in so many that have been deceived. And they've gotten shallow, or they've allowed things to creep in that has nothing to do with God. For the Lord says, what has righteousness to do with unrighteousness? What has circumcision to do with uncircumcision? You hear what he's saying. Salvation plan established for all. As I break down every wall that has kept my church back, putting them back on track. Come one, come all, is Christ's divine call. I am waiting with outstretched arms. My power will keep you from all harm. Whoa, he tells us what he's about to do to this earth to wake up the people. But in the same breath, he's telling us over and over that in him, he will guard us. He will keep us from all harm. Praise God. I watch over you like a hen does her chicks. And in my church, there are no cliques. Oh, people of God, I have been in churches, more than one, different denominations, where the right doesn't talk to the left, the hallelujah side doesn't talk to the amen side or the glory side. There's even division among the body of Christ, and he said there'll be no cliques, not in my church. Not in my church. Love binds and prevails. All Satan's plans will fail. Three times in this one message, he has talked about the demise of Satan. He will not prevail. All his plans will fail. Hold on to the strong arm of Jesus. He's coming through for us. He's coming through for us. I am who I am. There is none like me. My strength and power abides in thee. Use the authority of my name, and many souls you will claim. Use the power of his name. Jesus in us. His anointing, his holiness, his righteousness, his power, his authority abides in those who receive him as Lord and Savior. And he will not forsake them who serve him. My banquet table will be full, for from hell many souls you will pull. The destitute, the deprived, they will become strong and wise. The weak I will make strong as I right all that is wrong. That will change to this as I give the earth a little twist. More insight, more revelation. The enemy will try to rise. Be watchful, and you will see his demise. I have prepared a pit for him, and he is standing on the rim. Ooh. The Lord is about to take charge. People, look out for whatever's coming. All evil will bend when I say the end. For my people will get a reprieve as a harvest of souls they receive. Changing a smile for a frown, bitterness for a crown. What a time it will be as we cross the river, you and me. Ooh, what a mouthful he has said here. The enemy will try to rise. Be watchful, and you will see his demise. I have prepared a pit for him, and he is standing on the rim. Ooh, people, hallelujah to the Lamb. All evil will bend when I say amen. This will be a time of reprieve for my people to receive a harvest of souls. Changing a smile for a frown, bitterness for a crown. What a time it will be as we cross the river, you and me. We're a team, you and I. Together we will fly to places unknown where seeds I have sown. 1 minute here, 1 minute there. You will carry my word everywhere. People need to hear, so grab up your heavenly gear, going from shore to shore as I open each door. The enemy will come, but I have already won. Just keep praising me, and it will keep confusing him all of these days. Praise be unto God. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Ooh, hallelujah to the great I am. You need to listen to this again and again. Encourage yourself. Be lifted up by the words that he says to you today. Hallelujah. And then I say, I am expecting a miracle around the bend where all that we have been through will end. In our new expectations, there will be temptations, but your power and your love will guide each step as you have since the day we met. New challenges will come, the battles you have already won. We're talking about the Lord. The plan to speak to you first. This has got to be our plan. How many times has he said, communicate and wait. Wait and communicate. Communicate and wait. Wait on me. Communicate with me before you move. The plan to speak is to speak to you first, and all the enemy's plans will burst. Flames of fire will help meet our every desire. I feel like these flames of fire he's talking about are the angels that serve us, the angels that come around us, that help us, the angels that will help fight our battles, the angels that we can't see in the natural realm, but they're out there. Just like was Elisha said, open the eyes of the servant that he can see, the army that's behind us. Ooh, hallelujah, hallelujah, halalamo shanda labo si karama shandai, glorie makushende rima si kalabahaya. There is no one like our God. The plan to speak to you first, and all the enemy's plans will burst. Flames of fire will help to meet our every desire. When heaven touches earth again, many will bow at my feet. I will change their heart and give them a new start. Brushing off their tattered clothes, he said that before, saying goodbye to past woes. Seeing I paid the cost and I filled them with the spirit of Pentecost, now they go to win the lost. I am in the room and I am taking away all gloom and doom. As in the east the sun does rise, you will see the enemy's demise. How many times has he said that to us? He repeats and repeats and repeats. Why? We need to hear it and hear it and hear it. When we hear it, that's why the Lord says, when you talk to me and when you pray and when you praise, do it aloud. Don't be afraid of who's going to hear you. Do it out loud, because it goes into the atmosphere and it changes the atmosphere and it changes what you feel inside. All the fear disappears and everything becomes clear. Brushing off your tattered clothes, saying goodbye to past woes, seeing I paid the cost and I have filled you with the spirit of Pentecost, and now you go win the lost. I am in the room, cleansing it all of all gloom and doom. As in the east the sun does rise, you will see the enemy's demise. As the sun sets in the west, a reprieve from all trials and tests. People, we are going to have a reprieve. And that doesn't mean you aren't going to be tempted or tried. Oh, the devil's still out there. But it means that there's going to be such a spirit of Jesus that rises up in us, a boldness of Peter and all the disciples is just going to come forth, and we're going to go out and win this last harvest. Praise God. Listen to what he says here. As the sun sets in the west, a reprieve from all trials and tests. But remember, the devil's out there waiting with a snare to trip you up while I'm filling your cup. So that says exactly what I just said. And if I would just read it, I wouldn't have to improvise it myself to try to tell you what it means. Because that's exactly what he said. There'll be a boldness rise up within us. While he is filling our cup, the enemy's going to try to trip you up. But he can't do it, because the Lord is guarding you. In Isaiah 52:12, it says that he goes before us and he guards our back from any of the enemy's attack. While I'm filling your cup, I wrap you in my arms tight while we are taking this flight. Ooh, hallelujah. And then he says, do not touch my anointed ones back to hell from where you come. Ooh, for I have already won. And that's the power we have in us this morning. We can say, do not touch the anointed of the Lord back to hell from where you came from, for we have already won. My people marching as one till all the work on earth is done. Trials will come and go, but this they know. They come to me on bended knee, for I am the key to total victory. You never have to wonder. The devil is down under. I am the head and you are my feet. Always stay humble and meek. I will direct so you don't have to sweat. Righting the wrong as we march along, singing a new song in his love where we belong. Ooh, the Lord just wants to lock you up in those arms of love where the devil can't touch you. He just thinks he can. Come on. Come on. We serve a God who created the galaxies, time, space, dominion. It's all created in him. We are in love, you and I. I will take you where eagles fly. How many times has he said that to you? Above the clouds of life where there is no trouble or strife. This is where trusting in the Lord with all our heart comes into play. So many times there's things in our life that we kind of want to keep in a little corner that we just want to keep. But the Lord says, trust me with all your heart. Do not lean on your own understanding. In all ways, acknowledge me. Not just 99%, but in all ways, acknowledge me, and I will direct your path. I will keep you from all harm. I will protect you. I will wrap you up in my arms. How many different ways can he say it? There is a place in me you want to be. In my timeline, the enemy I will bind. The smile on your face as we embrace, a little more of heaven you will taste, and time you will not waste. The Lord is speaking to us today, telling us, you know, you may feel like you're in a place, I know I have, since all these things have been happening. God opened a door for me to go to college, and then all of a sudden that door closed and he said, I want you to go here instead of there. We've been so many different places and gone through so many things. My husband's had a promise to restoration for 12 years. We are believing every day. When I get up in early to pray, sometimes I hear a noise and I believe it's him coming down the hall, completely restored, because God said it would happen. And I believe God over anything I see in the natural. For I serve a supernatural God, and he says we need to believe supernaturally. The Lord said, I am who I am, and there is none like me. I will fill you up like the leaves on an evergreen tree. And then when he said that, fill you up like leaves on an evergreen tree. Evergreen tree represents Christ also. He is and always has been. And he's constantly enriching. And the leaves are full on this tree year round. I feel so small and you are so tall. You break down every wall and will not let me fall. Lord, you are so beautiful to me. I want the whole world to see the Christ who died for me on the cross of Calvary. I want to walk through heaven's gates where with outstretched arms for me you wait. Just that thought. I want to see my loved ones passed on before. But first of all, I want to see Jesus saying, welcome, my faithful one. Your work on earth is done. But most of all, I want to see him face to face and thank him for his amazing grace. If it hadn't been for that grace and that mercy covering me, there's no telling where I would be. And he say, enter into the joy of the Lord, where with me you will live forevermore. Praise be unto God. What a blessing this morning. He has graced us with his word. He has graced us with his presence. He has graced us, mothers in particular. He has warned us. He has given us revelation. He has told us how much he loves us and he protects us. That's the God we serve. He doesn't demand, he commands. We are not servants, we're friends. What's the difference? A servant, he doesn't reveal things to. A servant, we in the natural would not reveal things to. But a friend, you talk to. You talk to. He is my best friend, my protector, my provider. Ooh, hallelujah to the Lamb. You are Jehovah, God of creation. You are Jehovah, Lord God Almighty, the God of Israel, the everlasting one. You are Jehovah, the God that heals me. I forgot the rest of it all of a sudden. Maybe I'm just not supposed to sing it. I need to let you go. But I want to tell you, I love you. Jesus loves you so much more. All you got to do if you don't know him is bow a knee and say, come into my heart. With all your heart, ask him to come in. And if you do know him and you've walked afar off, listen to this over and over again. He loves you so much. I love you, but he loves you so much more. God bless, and we'll see you hopefully tomorrow.